So hey everybody, this is Michael again. Thank you all for joining me on the channel today. You know, a while back I had started doing coronavirus live stream updates, and that was pretty close to when it was really getting out of hand. But I hadn't made one of those updates in a long time, and I usually do them live, but you know, live videos are really hard for me to do because I just don't have adequate privacy a lot of the time. So I decided to just record my coronavirus update this time. So, you know, the last time I made a coronavirus video update, I think that I knew of a friend whose family caught it out of state. But since that time, you know, I got to say that my ex, her mom, her brother and sister have all been inflicted with the virus. They've gotten better now. This has been about a month ago, so they're all doing well now. Another good friend and her family caught it, and it was a struggle for her, but she did beat it and she got better. It hit closer to home when my aunt, who's 95 years old, actually was, she tested positive for the virus. She went into the hospital, 95 years old. So when that was announced, she lives out of state with her son and his wife. But when that was announced, I just, you know, assumed the worst because I thought, you know, she's older and, you know, she already has medical issues being that age and all that. But to my surprise, she pulled through. She actually, you know, kicked a coronavirus's ass and left the hospital. She's a tough old lady, man. And wow, when you have people that are, you know, 20s, 30s, 40s that are dying of this thing, and a 95-year-old gets it, and, you know, we've all heard that mostly seniors are the ones that get the brunt of this damn virus. Lots of them don't make it. So when she got it, we just feared the worst, but she pulled through, and that was such a big relief because I love my aunt, and, you know, 95 years old, that's an accomplishment and by any rights. She's still in her right mind, you know. She's still got a lot of life in her. And I'm really happy that she survived and got better. You know, I've always kind of worried about the disease because, you know, there's this thing out there where, you know, some people feel like not a lot really going on with it, and that, you know, a lot of this is hoax, and you know, we don't want to wear a mask, and it's our rights, and all this kind of stuff. I've always been a little bit worried because I've always taken safety precautions, you know, the mask and hand sanitizer and all that kind of stuff. And I won't mention any names because, you know, illness for some is very, very personal. And far be it from me to get on the World Wide Web and announce names, but I was exposed to the coronavirus. Two people that I see on a daily basis tested positive for it. I was around both these people. So I was exposed to it. And it really, you know, I found out the day before Christmas. So that means that, or that meant that the people that were going to come to the house, we didn't have a whole bunch, but the people that were going to come, and I immediately, you know, called them and said, hey, you know, this happened. I don't feel like it's safe. You know, Merry Christmas, but keep your ass at home. Okay. I didn't say it like that, but that's basically what I meant. But, so they stayed at home, and, you know, it kind of sucked because, you know, there were certain people that I really wanted to see, but you know, you got to do what you got to do. So they stayed at home, and I scheduled a test the very next day. And you know, it's kind of amazing because I mean, you know, some people think, well, you get it, it's a cold, you get over it, but you just never know. You never know. And so, I actually, went and got tested, And the testing process, oh yeah, both nostrils, that was a joy. But anyway, I got tested, and my test results ended up being negative. I didn't have it, which, I am around the people quite a bit, but even still, I always practice, the mask and all that kind of stuff for the most part. And I tested negative, and one of my concerns was that, if I was positive, I would, potentially expose my better half, my kids, my friends, strangers. If you really think about what one person with this virus could do, it could really just like exponentially just blow up. So I really had a couple of restless nights thinking about it because, and your fucking mind just starts playing all kind of fucking tricks on you. It's like, oh, I've got the sniffles. Oh man, do I have a fever? Oh man, I feel sore. Man, my nose is running. I mean, your body, it's like, it senses just a little bit of concern, and then your body's just like, yeah, let's fuck with this guy. And so that was the restless nights I had, just, my body egging me on and making me think that something was wrong. It's kind of like when you go to the store and somebody sneezes, which could be a very innocent thing, and you're thinking, oh my God, they've got it. They've got it. So yeah, that's my experience with the coronavirus so far. It's a really scary thing. It's a really scary thing. I mean, I'm not one of those people that believe that, oh yeah, if I get it, I can beat it. You just never know. You just never know. Because there's been healthier people than me that have, succumbed to this thing. So, I just wanted to share that story. Another episode in the coronavirus update, and let you all know about it. It's I'm just gonna say, guys, I know some of you might be or have an aversion to wearing a mask and all this kind of stuff, but I'll just say, protect yourselves, man. Just be safe because this shit's out there. And yeah, even if you think that, well, it's just the flu or cold or whatever. Well, the flu kills. The point is, yeah, the flu does kill, and this shit kills too. And you don't want to die regardless. So just be safe. Just be safe. Protect your family, and protect your elderly in the family because they're really vulnerable. And just be safe, guys, because one death is too many. And when you have several hundred thousands, that's tragic, man. That's just tragic. Death is such a tragic thing. And when you see people that have lost husbands and wives and kids and all that, it's so fucking tragic. But anyway, guys and girls, if I feel the need to do another coronavirus video update, I will. But in the meantime, hopefully we won't have any more. Hopefully we won't have anything else happen. Thanks for watching, everybody, and wholeheartedly, I just say, be safe, be careful, be mindful, and look out for your loved ones. All right. Thanks for watching. Take care of yourselves, everyone, and I'll see you in the very next video.